We're going to draw cards from a well-shuffled deck of 52 without replacement. What is the probability of drawing a 6 or a jack as the first and only card that you draw? One way to do this problem is just to look at the number of 6s and the number of jacks in the deck and add them together. We have 8 cards that are either a 6 or a jack. Out of 52 total, that fraction reduces to 2/13, which is a great answer. There's another way to look at this problem. We know a formula for OR problems that goes like this. The probability of drawing a 6 or a jack is the probability of drawing a 6 plus the probability of drawing a jack minus the probability of drawing a 6 and a jack. So how many ways can we draw a 6 out of this deck? Well, there are 4 6s out of 52 cards. The same is true for a jack. The probability of drawing a jack is 4 out of 52. And then the question is, how many ways can we draw both a 6 and a jack? Well, there aren't any cards that are both 6 and a jack in the deck. Those two things can't happen at the same time, so this probability that we're subtracting off is 0 out of 52. A little vocabulary that we know to describe the situation. Drawing a 6 from the deck and drawing a jack from the deck are mutually exclusive events. Both can't happen at the same time. So it looks like our probability is going to turn out to be 8 over 52 again, which again reduces to 2/13. So no matter how you do this problem, the probability works out the same. The next question is, what is the probability of drawing a 6 and a jack as the only card that you draw? Again, drawing a 6 and drawing a jack are mutually exclusive, so the probability is 0. You cannot draw both at the same time. The next problem is, what is the probability of drawing a 6 as the first card and then a jack as the second card? So this is a different kind of a problem. We have two experiments here, and we want the probability of both of those experiments happening back to back. This is what we call an AND problem, or as I like to call an AND THEN problem. And to complete the problem, what we need to do is multiply the probability of drawing a 6 by the probability of drawing a jack, but keep in mind that this probability of drawing a jack is dependent on the first draw. So we know that the probability of drawing a 6 is 4 out of 52, and once we've drawn that 6 from the deck, you'll remember that we're doing these problems without replacement, so we don't put that 6 back into the deck. Then the probability of drawing a jack is 4 out of a total of now 51 cards. Multiplying these fractions together gives us 16 over 2652, which reduces to 4 over 663 as our final probability. And really quickly, I'll show you how to enter this into your calculator so that you can get that fraction. We're multiplying 4/52 by 4/51. Our calculator will spit out a decimal typically. If we want to tell the calculator to give us a fraction, we can hit this math button, we can hit enter, and then we can hit enter one more time, and it gives us our reduced fraction. All right, the next video in this playlist is going to be about statistics. I'll see you there.